This is Zhang Po and welcome to Zhey-Go-Bay-Gay. From now on, we will be focusing only on Bhutanese dishes. And to move on with, the first dish that we have is Bumdap Khule with Ematati. So I'm sure a lot of people, you all probably know how this dish is made, but we'll just follow a very simple procedure on how to do this. Okay, so first of all, I take an empty bowl and this is buckwheat. Buckwheat flour. So we put a little bit of buckwheat flour here. Then you add some water. Put some water here. Okay, then you have to mix this. Normally when there's so many other options that you have, you can put oil in this one, and people also like to put butter in this. But we are going to follow the very simple way of making this. So okay, we need to add some more water here. So the consistency has to be very smooth. Okay, keep mixing it. We do not want any lumps here. So mixing it again. In case if you feel that your consistency is a little thin, you can add some more buckwheat flour for this one. Okay. I don't see any lump and it's easy flowing now. Okay, so in the meantime, what I do is I will heat our pan here. Heat the pan properly. Okay. This is the consistency that should be. So what we do is we use some cotton here. Cotton, we dip it in oil and you spread it on your pan. This is just so that your khule will not stick and it will be easy for you to remove it later on. Okay, our pan here is hot, so we put one whole scoop over here. So just spread this here, and now you have to be a little quick for this. You spread it gently. You spread this. Okay, so you just have to wait. You would actually need to see little bubbles coming out. That means the lower part is cooked. Then you can turn it to the other side. So we'll probably just have to wait to see bubbles now. Okay, I can see a few bubbles coming out. Alright. There are a few bubbles which are actually popping out. This is a work of patience. So, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn it on the other side. Turn it here. Okay, it's perfectly done. Okay, then you lower your flame so that you do not burn your khule. Okay. Just when we keep this aside, we'll keep this here. We'll go ahead with one more. Some more hot oil again. And be quick to spread it. Quick to spread it. And again, we wait for bubbles. Okay. Okay, now I can see a few bubbles. Time for us to turn this khule here. Okay, we turned it. And this is normally what we do when so that your khule doesn't get cold. We put the earlier khule on top. So in the meantime, we will make a curry to go with this khule. I take a pan here. let's heat this one, but we'll keep the kulay in low flame. So I take a pan, water, about 1 cup, okay, in full flame. Then I have some green chilies here. Then we cut the green chilies. We're just going to make the emadati for just one serving. Okay. Okay. Then we put salt to taste. Some oil. You can use any oil, and if you would like, you can also use butter, but I think butter is very fattening, so we used refined oil in this one. So basically what you do is you just bring this emadati to boil. So in the meantime, we'll check on our kulay as well. Keep on top of each of the term, but keep it at low flame. So we'll get our cheese ready here. The cheese that we have here is the cottage cheese, which we normally call as tatsi, and the Britannia cheese that we have. And a combination of both the cheese is really good. It sort of gives a mixed flavor. Actually, that's the way I like it. Cheese, it's entirely up to you how much you use. So I'm going to put, like I said earlier, I like a mixture of both the cheese. So I'm going to put a little bit of both the cheese here. Okay, now you can hear the boiling sound. I did not put much because we're just waiting for the emadati to be cooked. We'll just dry the soup just a little bit drier than this, because then you will also know that your emadati is actually cooked. And this is one of, I'm sure all the viewers out there know that this is one of the favorite dishes among the Bhutanese here, which is hot and spicy. Okay. Okay, now we're trying to melt. You can stir it after a while. The preparation time is just about 3 minutes for this emadati, and the kulay would just take you about 2 minutes. This is a very quick meal, actually. Okay, our emadati is almost done. One tip for our viewers is, if you keep stirring your emadati, your cheese would melt better, and then you would know, you would actually spread your cheese to all the chili over here. Okay, so the emadati is done. So I put off the kulay in the meantime. Okay, and we will serve it. Okay, our emadati is ready. And then we take out the kulay over here, two kulays. And just like how the bumtap say, a kulay is incomplete without some butter, but that's entirely upon how you all like it, like how they say, Kurbu Jaido Marioks Ngamzawa. I hope the viewers out there enjoyed watching this program as much as I've enjoyed hosting it. Thank you very much for watching.